Hey folks, after yesterday's video, Baphometrics asked me how I realized this bass sound inside Bitwig. And this bass sound here. And this is a pretty simple setup. It's phase 4 only. And in the chain are a multipoint FX2 device, some EQing, 3 EQs, and a little bit of modulation on the EQ side. And that's it, basically. I have one saw operator here, one Y operator for the noise, and a sine operator mixed in with a lot of modulation, as you can see here. And as the track progresses or the sound progresses, I have this envelope here, which modulates the speed of the LFO. As you can see, the attack is coming in and then the LFO is slowly slowing down. Also, I modulated with the envelope, I think, yeah, the filter, and a little bit of the EQ. Pretty simple, not really complicated setup. But I'm not done yet with the video, so I want to create a new patch, fresh patch with the new phase 4. And yeah, let's try it. So at first I have everything turned off, every operator, only one is active, it's the first one here, and I try to create some kind of nice bass. Then I turn on the second one and I mix it in via this knob here. This creates at first a nice mid-range tone, and as I told in my last tutorial about modulations, use small modulations everywhere. So I exactly do that. Create a random one. Or let's use an LFO to have it more like an more real rhythmic feel. And then in my other patch I use this one here, this operator, and I use it to create noise. And I create noise with using or mixing this operator to itself with this knob. So yellow into yellow. So you basically create just random noise. And then I mix this operator into this red operator here with this knob. So I mix yellow into red. But also just slightly. Or you can do it the other way around. Then maybe I detune this operator here a little bit so it's not so static. Thank you. and I use an envelope. Oh no, not a follower. So small modulations to all kinds of parameters. They have a changing or evolving sound. There's an FX2, so I can separate some frequencies. Use another EQ. So what this does is basically cuts out the frequencies from the low band to the high band. And push again the upper frequencies. And use the envelope modulator again. Okay. And yeah, modulate this too. And maybe you can also modulate the pitch a little bit. Yeah, maybe like this. And then, I don't know. Can't use an amp, maybe push again upper frequencies. No limits to your creativity, so yeah, or maybe you can use a plot device inside the FX chain here, so we only have stereo effects on the top bands. Upper bands. Yeah, I can do this basically for hours, but you get the point. Do smart modulations on every parameter, like I told you in the other tutorial. Use basic concepts, but stack simple stuff on top of each other, and then you get a much complexer result in the end. I think I upload the patch for this sound in my GitHub repo, so you can download it and tweak it around or use it in your own tracks. And yeah. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Leave me a comment if you have questions and leave me a like. Until next time, see you and bye.